Hello guys, and welcome to my channel ChemoFacts. So my name is ramkrish.mngd, a student of Kirolimal College Chemistry Honours. Today I'm here to explain you on the topic benzoin condensation by green method. So normally hum to benzoin condensation pehle se karte aaye hain, but that was using cyanide reagent, jo ki ek toxic reagent hai, which is definitely not good for our environment. So in this experiment we'll learn that how we can perform the benzoin condensation by a greener method. So now let us start our experiment. So first of all, hamara aim yahi hai that to carry out benzoin condensation by green method and determine percentage yield. So here are the apparatus that are required for the experiment. One is round bottom flask and then the normal flask, ice water bath, these are the things. And let us now see what are the chemicals required for this experiment. So the chemicals are benzaldehyde, obviously, then thiamine hydrochloride, here this is the greener reagent that we are going to use, then sodium hydroxide, ethanol and distilled water. So now let us focus more on this experiment. So before knowing anything about the greener method, हमें पहले ये जान लेना चाहिए कि previous method क्या है. Benzoin condensation using the cyanide process. So now let us see cyanide use करके हम किस तरह से पहले benzoin condensation करते थे. So here is the definition कि the benzoin condensation is a coupling reaction between two aldehydes that allows the preparation of alpha hydroxyketone. See, clearly we can see in the image that we are reacting one benzaldehyde, one aldehyde with the cyanide ion to form the benzoin. Okay, so this is basically the reaction which we were performing earlier by using cyanide. So let us see the mechanism also. Mechanism bhi dekh lete hain. So first of all, the addition of the cyanide ion. So the first step is the addition of the cyanide ion to the benzaldehyde that we have taken. So the cyanide ion will definitely, it will attack to the carbonyl carbon of the benzaldehyde. So as soon as it attacks the carbonyl carbon, the oxygen will be negatively charged. Matlab oxygen ke upar ek negative charge aa jayega, and then the negative charge ko stabilize karne ke liye it will definitely take one H from the solvent humne which we provide kara hai, and then we are also performing this in the presence of water, so it will get from there. Uske baad aapko ye product milega jo right corner mein hai, and then we'll move towards the step 2 of the mechanism, and that is the strong base will deprotonate the product form. As we have taken the strong base NaOH, so NaOH kya karega na ki ye deprotonate kar dega by taking this H. So it will form a carbon ion, and here is the resonance structures of the carbon ion formed. Now we'll move towards the step 3 of the mechanism, and it says ki jo humne benzaldehyde liya hai wo another benzaldehyde will react with the carbon ion. So the carbon ion will definitely, it will attack on the carbonyl carbon of the benzaldehyde, and again it will form a product where the oxygen will carry a negative charge, and just because it cannot sustain that negative charge, it will revert back to this position, and after that the cyanide ion will be removed from the product, and automatically we'll get our benzoin. So guys, abhi tak humne jo dekha and sikha, that was the benzoin condensation using the cyanide reagent, which is definitely not an eco-friendly process. So now let us see ki isme kya problems thi jiski wajah se hame greener method develop karna pada. So the problems are that the possible formation of hydrogen cyanide if the pH value was not properly controlled during the reaction or walk-up. So reaction ke time ya workup ke time agar the pH value was not properly maintained or controlled, then HCN will form, and that is harmful to our health. So this is definitely a biggest disadvantage of this reaction, you could say. Then hydrogen cyanide has a low boiling point, 25 degree Celsius, जो कि यू नो नॉर्मली हमारा रूम टेम्परेचर ही समटाइम्स इट यूज टू बी 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस. सो इतने में तो ये इवेपोरेट हो जाएगा, कहीं भी जा सकता है. देन इट इज़ हाईली टॉक्सिक, ये बहुत टॉक्सिक है. HCN इज़ क्वाइट टॉक्सिक एंड अबाउट 10-20% ऑफ ह्यूमन कैनॉट स्मेल द कंपाउंड ड्यू टू जेनेटिक ट्रेट. सो दीज आर यू नो सम ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट आर कॉज्ड बाई यूजिंग साइनाइड्स. So now let us see that what can we use instead of cyanide. So before knowing anything about the greener method, let us know that what is green chemistry, because it is only because of green chemistry that we are able to read the greener method of benzoin condensation. So here it goes. A green chemistry is the approach in chemical science that efficiently uses renewable raw materials, eliminating waste and avoiding the use of toxic and hazardous reagent and solvent in the manufacture. जैसे कि हमने अभी एक टॉक्सिक रिएजेंट दैट इज HCN को हमने रिमूव किया अपने मैन्युफैक्चर प्रोसेस से एंड वी विल यूज अ ग्रीनर रिएजेंट. एंड हियर आर सम ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल्स, टू बी एग्जैक्ट देर आर 12 प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ग्रीन केमिस्ट्री. यू कैन हैव अ लुक ऑन दीज प्रिंसिपल्स इफ यू वॉन्ट. So directly we will go to the greener method, and that is using thiamine. So the greener reagent that we are using here is thiamine. So before knowing anything about the reaction and the mechanism, let us know ki thiamine hai kya. So basically thiamine consists of a pyrimidine ring and a thiazole ring. So pyrimidine ring kya hoti hai? So it is, you know, a ring which contain a benzene ring which contain two nitrogen atoms. See, the first ring जो हमें दिख रही है यहाँ पे वो है pyrimidine, and the second ring जो दिख रही है हमें वो है thiazole ring. It contain one nitrogen and one sulfur in that. So this is the complete structure of thiamine. The lab uses the hydrochloride form, which is ionic and dissolves well in water. So हम भी use करेंगे thiamine hydrochloride, जो कि you know it dissolves well in water. That is why we are using that. Then the highlighted proton H is removed from the hydrochloride by the hydroxide ion. See the H which has been highlighted by the red color, वो है ना बहुत acidic है. Just because उसके पास उसके adjacent में जो N nitrogen है उसके ऊपर positive charge है, so definitely the H will be more acidic in nature. Then thiamine itself is pale yellow in color. अच्छा, yes, the thiamine color is pale yellow. So ये हमें identification में मदद आएगी बाद में. Now here are some you know aspects, green chemistry aspects. So this process is greener in many ways. First of all, safer chemicals are used, which reduces the danger in case of accident. No cyanide. जैसे कि हम cyanide use ही नहीं कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे, तो in case if any accident happens, then we need not to worry. Just because we are not using cyanide, जो भी हमें हमारे साथ होगा, that will be you know quite safer as compared to cyanide. Now dangerous waste prevention. जस्ट बिकॉज नो सियानाइड इज़ प्रेजेंट, सो हमारे पास कोई सियानाइड HCN निकलेगा नहीं, या फिर अदर हार्मफुल वेस्ट ही नहीं निकलेगा, बिकॉज हम सियानाइड ही यूज़ नहीं कर रहे हैं, हम तो ग्रीनर सॉल्वेंट यूज़ कर रहे हैं. सो डेफिनेटली जो भी वेस्ट निकलेगा वो भी समवॉट ग्रीनर ही रहेगा. देन हाई एनर्जी एफिशियंसी, नो रिफ्लक्स रिक्वायर्ड. सो इन दिस रिएक्शन हमें रिफ्लक्स करने की भी ज़रूरत नहीं है, सो डेफिनेटली इट सेव्स आवर एनर्जी. वेल, this is the reaction mechanism of the benzoin condensation reaction by greener method, or we can say using thiamine. Now, first of all, see, this is the structure of thiamine, and here the R dash represent the pyrimidine ring and the R represent the part which contain the OH. So the first step of the reaction is, in presence of OH minus, the acidic proton will be removed and it will form a carbon ion. Now that carbon ion will attack the carbonyl carbon of the benzaldehyde, and it will form this sort of complex. And here some steps are missing, like the formation of OH and
the removal of H, and after which it will form a carbanion. And once it form a carbanion, it will attack at the carbonyl carbon of another benzaldehyde, and hence it will form this complex. And now we can see in this complex one negative charge is present at oxygen, but we know that it cannot sustain a negative charge, so it will revert back and the thiamine part will be removed from the product, and finally we'll get the benzoin as our final product. So this is the mechanism of the benzoin condensation. Now I have another kind of mechanism with the thiamine hydrochloride. So here we have taken thiamine hydrochloride as a reagent. So you can clearly see the previous mechanism and this mechanism is somewhat similar. Here also we form a carbanion, and that carbanion again attack at the carbonyl position of the benzaldehyde, and the reaction follows the same procedure. So these are the reactions of the benzoin condensation process. Now guys, let us have a look on the procedure of the reaction. So the first procedure is dissolve the thiamine hydrochloride in water. So we have to dissolve the thiamine hydrochloride which we have taken in water. And the second one is add 95% ethanol to it, and then we will add 2N sodium hydroxide solution to it, and finally we'll add benzaldehyde to it, and then we have to mix well the reaction. And after mixing well, we will seal the flask with parafilm, then label the flask with anything, just label it and store it in the drawer, and then come back to the lab after 2 to 3 days to check if crystals did form. And the right side of the page contains some of the questions that definitely will strike to your mind, that why is 95% alcohol is added. So it is added because to lower the polarity of the solution, as we know that we have taken water as solvent and water is a polar solvent, so to reduce the polarity we add ethanol to it. And here are some more obvious questions, and if you like then please have a look on it. Then now let us move further towards the more procedure steps, and after that we will place the flask with crystal in an ice bath. You know, this ice bath should contain plenty of water with some ice cubes for additional cooling, and then isolate the solids using vacuum filtration. Okay, we'll isolate the solid using the vacuum filtration, and after that wash the crystals with a small portion of ice cold water and ice cold 95% ethanol, and then after sucking air through the crystals, place them on a watch glass or in an open beaker to allow them to dry until the next meeting. So after drying, you will get your crystal, that is the benzoin crystal, and after that you can calculate the yield, or you can calculate the melting point, or whatever you want. And then here are some of the characterizations: the melting point, the infrared spectrum, etc., etc. Now comes the calculation part. Here we have to calculate the percentage yield of the reaction, and the formula of which is theoretical mass divided by the experimental mass into 100. We have to calculate percentage yield because it measures the reaction's efficiency, and the theoretical yield is based on the limiting reagent. This allows the researchers to determine how much product can actually be formed based on the reagent present at the beginning of the reaction. And finally, we will write the result of the reaction. The result is as follows. The benzoin was synthesized from benzaldehyde using thiamine and sodium hydroxide as the catalyst. Now yield and melting point of the reaction, you will mention it respectively. Then here are two of the precautions that we need to follow while performing the reaction. The first one is the solution should be single phase. Both components are soluble with each other before heating. If they are not separated, then ethanol is added. The second precaution is we should not heat it more than 65 degrees Celsius, just because it can cause undesirable side reactions. So that is why we should restrict our temperature to 65 degrees. So these are the two precautions that we need to follow while performing the experiment. So this is all, guys, and thank you very much for listening so patiently. Thank you all.